Hello and welcome to Zigwheels. We are here at the launch of what most likely is the most important bike of the year, or rather a pair of bikes, and those are the Pulsars, the new Pulsars, the largest Pulsars ever made. These are the Pulsar 250s. This, as you can see, the fed version is the Pulsar F250, and behind those guys out there is the naked, the N250. But we will get to that one in just a bit. First, let's focus on what is up with these Pulsars. Now, these are all new bikes, so everything in there is new. Brand new chassis, brand new engine, brand new everything. Now, these are not based on any of the older Pulsars or even the KTM based Pulsars like the NS or the RS. Now, in terms of chassis, it's got a tubular frame, which is quite standard, not like a twin spar frame like you get on the NS or the RS. And the engine, that's a fairly simple 249cc air-cooled motor with a two-valve head. Now, this of course makes 24.5 PS of power and 21.5 Newton meters of torque, which when you compare it to something like the 220, it's more power and more torque. Even when you compare it to something like the 200 NS, it's the same amount of power, but this makes more torque. And Bajaj has kept this engine quite simple, or the whole bike rather simple, for the one main reason, and that is to keep the price down. And speaking of price, this Pulsar, the F250, this is priced at ₹1.40 lakh ex showroom, and the naked one out there, that is priced at ₹1.38 lakh ex showroom. So they are priced quite well and quite low. When you compare these two, it's their competition, something like the NS200, for example, that's priced at 1.33 lakh. The 220F, that comes in at ₹1.36 lakh, about approximately. And even something like the FZ25, that's about 1.37 lakh rupees. So in that sense, these are only slightly more compared to the similar Pulsars or its competition in that sense. So let's quickly explore the little design details of this motorcycle. Now, this has a half fairing, this is the F version after all, and this gets an LED projector headlight and LED DRLs up at the front. The indicators are also LED, and around the back, of course, you have an LED tail light, which slightly resembles the one that you have on the Dominar. Now, this design actually does look quite nice. It's got nice white tail panels and this dual tone thing happening, like two panel thing happening, quite not similar to what you get on the Dominar as well. And when you talk about this front end design, it kind of looks like a combination of the 220 Pulsar and the Pulsar AS200, which Bajaj had launched some years ago. But overall, I would say it is a pretty nice looking bike. The F also gets clip-on handlebars, while the naked gets a normal flat handlebar. And of course, split seats are standard on both bikes, and they are quite spacious. In terms of seat height, it is 790mm, which is comparable to something like the Yamaha FZ25, which is quite low. And of course, talking about size, well, this fuel tank is 14 liters, looks quite chunky and should give you decent range as well. Now, let's quickly come to the console that you get on these Pulsars. Now, Bajaj calls this an Infinity console, something that has no bezels, and it does look quite nice. Now, Bajaj has maintained an analog tachometer, and of course, you have a digital speedometer, a gear position indicator, a clock, fuel gauge, odometer, etc. So, it is quite informative in that sense. It's also got telltale lights on the left, but it still maintains that slightly old school feel that you expect from a Pulsar. And in terms of switchgear, of course, it's all backlit. Nothing really out of the ordinary there, but what we can say, the quality of the switchgear does feel quite nice. So this is the Pulsar F250. Does look quite sweet. Before we go to the naked, just let's take a look at the tires real quick. Now, these are 100 section at the front and the rear. That's a 130 section. So in that sense, not really over tired. So should be quite light in terms of handling as well. And even this exhaust, this looks pretty sweet, short and stubby. very well designed. Now quickly let's take a look at the Naked. So coming to the Naked, and we might just disturb Rishabh for 2 seconds to get a quick walk around of the bike.
No. So, actual dibs. So I'm actually shooting, sorry.
Okay, just give me 1 second.
Thank you, Zigbee.
So this is the Naked. As you can see, pretty much identical to the F in every way, except for of course this front fairing, which is a bikini fairing, but it's got the same pressure headlight and LED DRLs, and of course no windscreen up front. And of course the handlebar here is a single piece handlebar, same console as well. And in terms of looks, well, it does look quite beefy and chunky, but we still think the F looks the nicer of the two. But what do you guys think? Let us know in the comments below of which would be your pick of the two, the Naked or the Fed. But that's it for the Pulsars. Now let's just quickly leave these guys to their shoot and check out, go back to the Fed one. So as you mentioned, the Pulsars priced at ₹1.40 lakh ex showroom for the Fed, ₹1.38 lakh ex showroom for the Naked. Now we will be riding these bikes really soon, in fact the day after tomorrow itself, and our reviews are going live on the 11th of November. So do stay tuned for that. Do hit the subscribe button and also click on that little bell icon so you're notified as soon as our review video of the Pulsars drop. And if you have any questions about these bikes that you want us to answer in the review, drop those in the comments as well. So that's it from the Pulsar launch in Pune. Okay, before we go, just a quick tease of the exhaust note for you, thanks to our friends RR at Autocar. So yeah, they do sound quite nice. Very basic exhaust note, but yeah, that is the Pulsar. So yes, as I said, do stay tuned, do share and subscribe, do hit that bell notification icon, and we'll catch you guys very soon. I'm PD signing off from the Bajaj office in Akurdi. Thank you so much for watching.